Ndiya sema tu jina langu.
Hiyo tu.
I don't know if this inasikika.
Inasikika.
My name is Sam. Yes.
Sam.
Yes.
All right, 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 right. Right.
What's up, guys? My name is Chip.
Chip. Okay.
What up, guys? My name is Ricky Gathariki.
Ricky Gathariki.
Yes.
Yeah.
Alafu kuna huyu.
Kuna moja. Yes, two.
This is Waithera. This is Mela. They couldn't make it, but they are with us in spirit.
All right. Well, it's good at least we're represented. Yeah, if they're watching or they get to watch the interview on the tube, Wagwan to you. Let's talk about the album and, you know, putting it together. Before we even talk about reasons the song you're going to perform, but talk about the album and putting it together. How has that experience been for y'all?
We started putting the album together, I think, around one and a half years ago. Wow. Immediately after we came from South Africa from our competition, Old Mutual Amazing Voice. Immediately after we won.
Yeah.
Old Mutual's Amazing Voices. Let them know.
Yeah.
We were able to get some money. And so when we came back home, we were in the middle of the pandemic.
Yeah.
The pandemic has just hit, which gave us a lot of quote-unquote free time for us to lock ourselves somewhere in the middle of Rongai, call a bunch of producers and songwriters, sit down and create the album that is right now, Wana Vokali, album.
And so when you had, how many songs, I'm sure when you're picking the album, for those who probably want to know a bit more in the process, right? So you had several songs and you had to pick a certain number. What informed you picking the ones that are on the album?
Okay, so from the writing camp where we secluded ourselves, we came out with like 22 songs.
All right.
And the criteria that we were using, we wanted songs that would show all of us as a group, first of all, singing in unison and showing our harmony. Mm-hmm. And then because each of us came from a background of being individual vocalists, everybody got their own song to lead in the album.
Right.
So there's six songs where there's leads of us six, and then five where it's all of us singing together.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right, and how is that, you know, in the writing camp, I don't know how it normally works, but what normally goes down?
It's harmonious. Writing together, mnajiseclude, some people go, they write the song with their own perspective, then they come and present it, and we all just chip in together. Kila mtu akona contribution kwa in the songwriting, yes.
And so... Right there, when now again you're coming up with the songs, right? And everybody has different styles. I don't know if that came out as well.
Yeah.
There are people who write on napkins. There are those who are like, I'm into freestyle. When you put your beat, I got this. There are those who write on their phones. How was that, you know, coming together of all of you? Like you said, how did that harmony kind of blend in with all the different aspects? Or there are people who are the same.
I would say that there are people who are the same.
Okay.
Because for us, even as you, if you listen to Wana Vokali, the album,
right,
we're selling diversity. Mm. We're six different personalities that are beautiful in their own way.
Right.
And we express ourselves differently, even musically.
Okay.
So there's no day that Sam would sound like Lina or Chep would sound like Ricky. It's Ricky and it's Lina. It's us being authentically Wana Vokali and you being you. So we're selling diversity. And so there's this unity in diversity. When you listen to the album, there are songs that we've done together, and then there are songs that now different individuals take different leads on the vocal. So I would say we're selling diversity, and we appreciate that we are very different personalities.
So would you say that's the vibe, like you want people to catch whenever when they listen to the album?
Yes.
To celebrate our diversity.
Yeah, celebrate our diversity, vocal prowess, music.
Right.
Yes, we want people to enjoy that.
To enjoy diversity. There is unity
in diversity.
In diversity.
Yes.
Come on. All right. Well, of course, let's talk about reasons. I know there are different songs, but now you're about to perform Reasons. Tell us about how that collab with, you know, Heart Band came through.
So, as I mentioned, when we did our writing camp, we were able to have a bunch of songwriters there, and one of the featured artists or songwriter that we had in our camp was Mordecai, aka Dex from Heart the Band. And so he actually just did a very nice post about it the other day. And he was like, he brought us two songs, Reasons and Amani.
Okay.
And then he was like, he presented it to us on a very hot afternoon and we were like, wow, those are amazing songs. And then we were fortunate enough to have six very beautiful voices that we could put oohs and beautiful ahs and beautiful harmonies on it.
Right.
And so, yeah, Reasons is just a very uplifting. I think it came also to the, when we us guys had it, it came to us at a very good time, at the right moment rather, because COVID has just happened. Things seemed to be so crazy. Things were happening in our personal lives, but then Mordecai just came with his guitar and he told us, kuna sababu, like there's a reason for each and every single thing you go through, and we were like, ah, let's put that in our album.
Yeah, man. Dex, na kwanga hivyo, napenda ku, you know, cheza hizo heartstrings za watu. Amazing guy. All right, and so for of course the album can be found on all platforms.
Yeah.
Watu waende mafanya katika ku stream. Kuna pale hivyo YouTube lakini ku stream ndio iko pesa. Fanya ku stream jameni.
Everywhere.
So one of calls the album.
Yeah.
The vibe they've said is diversity, and that's such an amazing thing for us now in what we're seeing even politically and even going through into next year. Mm-hmm. I think it's going to be one of those timeless albums as well. And the songs are going to be zibaki pale katika your mind and your psyche as you go through life. So they're going to do Reasons, but before that, tell the people where they can find you on social media. You can do find individual us. Or do you want to do...
We can all do it.
Yeah? Okay.
Yes, but find us on social media as at Wanavokali everywhere. Be it Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, everywhere.
Yes.
At Wanavokali, YouTube, at Wanavokali. Find us on all social media platforms as Wanavokali.
Okay.
Yes. Oh, and mine is, find me on Instagram as Lena. Lena, LENA. And then on Facebook as Lena again. Yes.
Okay.
For me, as my handle is at pronounced Roy.
Pronounced Roy.
Yeah.
All right, Wagwan.
Everywhere.
You can find me everywhere on the question, is that Chip? Is that Chip? Everywhere.
I like that. Is that Chip?
That Chip.
All right.
Mine is Ricky is Msani.
Very good.
Ricky is Msani. Uh-huh. Yeah.
All right.
Oh, let me just mention one final thing.
No problem.
As guys have released our second single from the album, which is Kula Tattoo, which is a song stroke video that has kind of showed. Yeah. That's also our second single from our album. It's a try on Gengetone. Yeah, it's our try. It's one of Vokali's entry into the Gengetone genre. But we've been getting a lot of feedback saying we sampled a lot of Kapuka vibes.
Yeah.
Which is nice because
which
most
is
of
the foundation
us
of
guys
Gengetone.
Are 90s, 2000 kids. So we are happy to represent that era. But yeah, Kula Tattoo video out now on YouTube, one of Vokali. One of Vokali, the album out now
everywhere.
Go stream, go listen. Yeah, have fun, vibe with it.
Also, if you want to catch us
on
live, we'll be performing at the Nairobi Street Kitchen on the 28th of November on Sunday from
this
2 p.m.
This Sunday,
come and enjoy the album. Come and have fun with us.
Yes.
We will be singing and performing songs from the album.
One sharing of a stage with Ketchup.
Ketchup from Nigeria.
Ketchup, no,
the Dynamics Band.
The Dynamics Band.
Yes, so make sure you come through. It's going to be amazing at the Nairobi Street Kitchen.
Come
right. So make sure, ukisema 28th, another sound. This Sunday.